The second missionary infected with the Ebola virus is back in the U.S. and receiving treatment in Atlanta. Nancy Reitball arrived at Emory Hospital Tuesday, and early reports indicate she is showing improvement. Her colleague, Dr. Kent Brantley, is also said to be getting better with the help of an experimental treatment. Her story has been closely followed by the mainstream media, which usually doesn't cover the lives of missionaries. But because of the Ebola outbreak in Africa, that is exactly what is happening. Recently, I went to Charlotte, North Carolina, Nancy Reitball's hometown, to learn more about why she went to Liberia and how her illness is affecting those closest to her.
59-year-old Nancy Reitball and her husband David are no newcomers to the mission field. They've worked around the world and as of last year with the missions organization SIM in Liberia. This war-torn country has few modern-day comforts and is known as a difficult mission post.
David and Nancy Reitball are two of the most humble people that I have ever met. Their concern is for sharing the gospel to the world.
Their missions pastor, Jim Cashwell, says the Reitballs recently felt called to use their gifts in administration and encouragement to help build up this hospital. It's desperately needed in a country where disease is common and doctors are few.
In Liberia, there are 50 doctors for 4 million people. They don't have the infrastructure because of the wars.
Nancy and her husband first felt the call to the mission field at a missions conference here at their home church in Charlotte more than 20 years ago. This spring, when Ebola began breaking out in Africa, the church asked them if they wanted to come home. Nancy and her husband said no.
We said, David, Nancy, let us bring you home. Let's wait until it gets safer before you return. And David and Nancy refused to come back because their statement was that they wanted to be where God had called them.
Not only did they stay, Nancy went to work on the front lines, helping to disinfect doctors and instruments used in the crisis.
You know, that's what Nancy was doing. When she's cleaning the instruments that are being used in the hospital, she's showing the love of Christ in a very practical way.
SIM President Bruce Johnson says the hope now is that Reitball and Brantley will recover, and that research around their treatment at Emory Hospital will ultimately lead to a cure.
Kent and Nancy are the kind of people that would say, I'm willing to do this, to sacrifice in order that many more would be saved.
As the world has watched this literal life and death battle unfold, back in Charlotte, Reitball's church is also watching and learning.
The faith of David and Nancy shows a maturity that I think is teaching all of us. They know that God can move in at any time and can heal Nancy. But they also recognize that if God chooses to call her home, that he's going to bring a healing there as well. And that's the healing that we all hope for.
This story is generating a lot of controversy as well. Should Ebola patients be allowed into the U.S.? You can post your comments at our CBN webpage, or you can join the discussion at our CBN News Facebook page.